imagine having the audacity to think that you could gatekeep joy. I mean, there is a war on Christmas, right? There is an organized effort to suck all the fun out of it, undermine its meaning, and winnow down its cultural importance until it's a non-event. But the side doing all that shit is the Christian side. I mean, we talk a lot about the pagan origins of Christmas, and rightly we should, like the trees, the lights, the mistletoe, the gift giving, the emphasis on joy and altruism. All of that shit predates the hostile Christian takeover. But there's also a huge chunk of shit on the other side that they want to nab the credit for, too. Like, for example, the fact that it's popular. I mean, they bitch and moan every chance they get about how corporations have commercialized Christmas and turned it into nothing but a marketing opportunity. But so the fuck what? That's what makes it awesome. The marketeers have done such a good job with your holiday that Jews had to bring a holiday up from the minor leagues just to satiate their kids. You motherfuckers should be thanking them, not condemning them. Consider what Christmas really is. And I don't just mean the modern American version. I mean the celebration itself throughout all time and across all nations. Right? Even if you set aside the pagan holidays that predated it, that means that along with the mall Santas and Whamageddon, we have to add Krampus and Icelandic murder cats and the candy pooping sacrificial log from Spain. But on top of all of that, you have to tack on puritanical regimes that forbade Christmas celebrations and the centuries upon centuries where it was just a public feast and a convenient theme for that week's sermon. And when you do that, what are you left with? What is the universal thing about Christmas? Presents? Obviously not. Those are, if anything, an on-again, off-again extravagance, historically speaking. Is it lights and trees? Well, I mean, given how many groups banned decorations of any kind for Christmas, it can't be that. Is it celebrating Jesus? Well, the fact that I've got a fucking tree full of presents downstairs disproves that assertion. Well, surely the date is universal, right? Well, unless, of course, you're Eastern Orthodox, in which case you celebrate it on January 7th. Hell, even the name falls short of universality since, you know, not everybody speaks English. So in reality, Christmas is a category rather than an individual thing. This wasn't always the case. I mean, I guess it was to some degree, but there was a time when the Catholic Church had a damn near iron grip on this holiday for most of the Christian world. And back then it was a more or less uniform celebration, or at least far more so than it is now. And also, and for the same reason, a much more boring holiday. And then in the relatively recent past, and we're talking really the last 100 years, marketers got a hold of it. And then a relatively boring feast day with better than average iconography became the holiday that every other celebration was measured by. Commercialization turned it into a holiday other religions were literally jealous of. It didn't get there through nativity scenes and candles. That shit was already there. Didn't get there through joy or happiness. Every holiday has that shit. It got there through a relentless, shameless, rapacious focus on consumerism. I mean, knock the free market all you want, but it makes for better holidays than religion does. You know, the parts that people responded to became ever more important, and the parts they don't like get pushed to the back of the line. And the parts people don't like are all the religious bullshit. Now, Christians can blame profiteering for taking the Christ out of Christmas all they want, but you can't have the one without the other. If it weren't for all the commercialization, there'd be nothing to fight over. Nobody puts out banners for Lent reminding people that penitence is the reason for the season, or screams about how we got to keep John the Baptist in Epiphany. Left to their own devices, religions make boring-ass holidays completely lacking in any meaningful tradition and any cartoon mascots. But you give Madison Avenue a month, and they'll make the fucking Feast of St. Francis of Assisi into some kid's cross days off a calendar's over. If you give it any real thought, you realize that Christianity should be sucking marketing's dick for what they did for Christmas. Taking the Christ out of it was the best thing that ever happened to the damn day. But of course, Christians can't acknowledge any of that while still taking credit for all the good parts of the holiday, so the marketers get quite the opposite of thanks. And look, I know I say some version of this pretty much every year, but I'm happy to split the difference. You guys can keep all the religious shit from your holiday, and the non-Christians can get all the consumerism that you so despise. Hell, we'll even let you keep the name. We'll call ours like Commercemas or something. Yeah, give it a couple of years. See who wins the most adherence. Look, a sign that says Jesus is the reason for the season is an admission of guilt. Even if it was true, which it quite demonstrably is not, it's a little like a director going to the theater to watch his own movie, then standing up in the middle of it and demanding that everybody acknowledge that they'd never get to watch that movie if it wasn't for him. So fucking what? Who fucking cares? If Dave Smith right, was the reason for the season. I feel like he'd be humble enough not to have to make any signs declaring it. But the fucking King of Kings, the Prince of Peace, is too fragile to just let a motherfucker enjoy the party. So yeah, I guess technically there is a war on Christmas, but the dreaded secular humanists have nothing to do with it. It's a war Christians are losing to themselves.